wisdom and values go together, and wisdom and ethics go together. And I guess we kind of need wisdom these days, because where wisdom shows its real value is when things are hard and decisions are hard to make. And maybe as leaders or decision makers, we're being pulled in different directions. So some of those decisions are always going to be hard to make. But if you don't understand your values, then it's much less clear to you what the correct decision is to make. So at least we can eliminate the difficulty in knowing what's the right thing to do, even if making that decision is still a hard decision because of the complexity of the situation and the possibility of major disruptive outcomes. So I guess in Australian universities, the classroom environment is much more informal. And for MBA students, we would tend not to use lecture theatres, except for maybe big introduction to management, introduction to marketing sort of courses. So we typically have small classes of about 30. And a lot of nearly all of the students would already have management experience. And so it's the interaction between students that's really quite different, and where they're talking about their own experiences, their own problems, and so on. So it's much more informal in Australia, and so MBA teachers are really more like facilitators rather than lecturers. So I think that would be the kind of the main difference. I mean, students are students, and I certainly see here the level of engagement with ideas that students have, how intensely focused they are on the things that I'm talking about. So in that respect, I think it's pretty much the same, and I know that it's really a big part of India's history and culture that people are interested in knowledge and learning, and becoming learned, in fact. So the feedback we get from business about what they're looking for students to do, what they think they're not so good at doing, number one is communication skills. You need to be really good at writing and really good at public speaking. So that's number one. Second one would be creativity and problem solving. So what employers in Australia are really saying is, we want students who, as soon as they see a problem, will take the initiative and try and solve it. Now, for a lot of students from Asian backgrounds, that's actually quite a difficult thing to do, because they're used to always waiting to be told. But I think, things are changing. And so employers, if you're a boss, what would you rather? Would you rather someone come to you with a problem, or someone come to you with a solution? So they want you to come to them with a solution in Australia. I think today, I guess one of the new things is design thinking. So we want people who are skilled at doing that kind of thinking, as well as critical thinking and critical analysis. But of course, critical analysis and design thinking, all of that goes together with problem solving and creativity and innovation. So I think those are the big things that employers really want, because ultimately what I'm doing is showing them that I have the capabilities to be a senior manager.